Hello friends, I'm Sharayu Pujari and I'm a verified educator on Unacademy. You can follow me on Unacademy learning app where you can find my other courses as well. So this lesson is on septic tank and also we are going to see its design parameters. So please do rate, review and recommend my courses and lessons. Do share this video and subscribe us on YouTube channel. Thank you. Hello friends, welcome to Unacademy and this lesson on septic tank by Sharayu Pujari. That's me. So about me, I am a verified educator on Unacademy. I have done my M.Tech in Environmental Science and Technology and B.E. in Civil Engineering. I have 2 years of experience in teaching and you can follow me on this link. So if you follow me, you will get notified every time I publish a new lesson or new course on this platform. So this is my profile on Unacademy where you can find my other courses. Like my previous course was on characteristics of sewage and also other courses which are on environmental engineering for gate so far. So please do rate, review and recommend my courses and lessons. Do share this video and subscribe us on YouTube channel. So friends, let's start with the new lesson, that is on septic tank, right? So generally septic tanks are provided in areas where sewers have not been laid. So the areas where sewer system is not available or where the sewers have not been laid, at that area septic tanks are provided, right? And also the septic tanks are provided for isolated communities or schools, hospitals and other public institutions. And septic tanks work best if the number of users is less than 300, right? So it works best. It can work for the users greater than 300, but it works best if the number of users is less than 300, right? So the septic tank is generally a sedimentation tank only, but it has longer detention time. So the detention time is from 24 hours to 48 hours with extra provisions for anaerobic digestion of settled sludge. So as I said, septic tank is a sedimentation tank only, but it is provided with longer detention time with extra provisions for anaerobic digestion of settled solids, right? So it is an anaerobic digestion process which has 3 stages, as I have explained in my previous lessons in sludge treatment, right? So next point is sludge collected at the bottom gets digested anaerobically. So here in septic tank, which the sludge is collected at the bottom, it gets digested anaerobically and the digested sludge is then periodically removed. So the digested sludge at the bottom of the tank is periodically removed. So the septic tank, it is a rectangular watertight airtight tank constructed with masonry or concrete, right? So it is constructed with masonry or concrete. So this is a section of a septic tank. Here the inlet zone is there, here influent is coming, that is inlet zone, and then it goes to the settling zone. So here in settling zone you can see the after the detention period the sludge gets deposited or settles at the depth or the bottom of the tank, and this is the depth of digested sludge or depth of the sludge zone, right? So this is the sludge zone and it is the depth of the sludge zone. This is the settling zone and its height is h is equal to, this is the liquid depth from here to here, and a free board is provided here. So the gases which evolve during the anaerobic digestion process are then passed through the vent shaft into the atmosphere at a particular height. So this is the outlet zone here. So effluent is then passed to the soak pit or cesspool, right? So this soak pit is provided for the effluents, right? So then the soak pits are also important. So here you can see effective depth is equal to overall depth minus freeboard. So effective depth is overall depth minus freeboard. If we do, we'll get the effective
depth. So this is the height of liquid or liquid depth, and this is the depth of sludge zone. This is the inlet zone. So this is the total length, that is L, right? So based on that, we are going to see now the design of septic tank. So capacity of septic tank, that is volume, is equal to volume of settling zone plus volume of sludge zone. So first we'll see what is volume of settling zone. So volume of settling zone is equal to Q into DT. Here Q is our dry weather flow. So it is number of users into per capita sewage flow. Number of users into per capita sewage flow, and detention time is 24 to 48 hours. So here we have seen the capacity of septic tank, that is volume. It is volume of settling zone plus volume of sludge zone. So volume of settling zone is Q into DT. Here Q is our dry weather flow, that is number of users into per capita sewage flow. And detention time is taken, it will be sometimes given in the question. If not given, then assume a number between 24 to 48 hours. So it is in hours, right? So next is plan area or surface area of septic tank, that is L into B. It is equal to volume of settling zone divided by liquid depth, or volume of septic tank upon effective depth, right? So this is the plan area. Then we'll see the volume of sludge or sludge zone volume. So it is equal to rate of sludge produced into number of users into desludging period. It is the volume of sludge or sludge zone volume is equal to rate of sludge produced into number of users into desludging period. So the rate of sludge production is equal to, this rate of sludge production is equal to 30 to 40 liters per person per year. This is rate of sludge production is 30 to 40 liters per person per year. And desludging period or cleaning period is equal to 1 year to 3 years for septic tank. So desludging period is, or cleaning period is 1 to 3 years for septic tank. Next, L by B ratio is 2:1 to 4:1. So you can assume any ratio between 2:1 to 4:1, and depth is from 1.5 meter to 2.5 meter. So this was the overall what we can say design parameters related to septic tank, and based on this we are going to see some solved examples on the design of septic tank in my next lesson. Also we'll see Imhoff tank, and then we'll see some MCQs related to septic tank. So friends, thank you for watching this video. I hope it was useful for you. If you have any doubts, you can let me know in the comments. I'll try to help you. So please do rate, review and recommend my courses and lessons. Do share this video and subscribe us on YouTube channel. Thank you.